Hi, I'm John Green. Welcome to my salon. This is Mental Floss Video, and did you know that a postman in southeast France spent 33 years building a palace made of stones that he picked up on his route? It started with one interesting rock he found in 1879. Eventually, he'd built a structure that tourists visit to this day. Anyway, that's the first of many facts about unique architecture I'm going to share with you today. Googie architecture was a style popularized in the 1940s and 50s. Basically, it means buildings designed to look futuristic, and a man named Eldon Davis is considered one of the fathers of Googie architecture. He didn't invent it, but he did help design thousands of California coffee shops in this manner. The Longaberger Company manufactures home decor, including baskets, and their headquarters in Ohio used to be a building shaped like a giant basket. It cost around $30 million to construct, and it was 160 times the size of the product it was modeled after. Then eventually they moved offices because, you know, it's not that fun to work inside of a giant basket. But speaking of baskets, the Pabellón de Aragón in Zaragoza, Spain is also meant to look like one, but it's a little more subtle with weaving panels of glass and concrete. In Sinaloa, Mexico, there are cemeteries containing mausoleums with extra features like air conditioning, running water, even cable television. In Sopot, Poland, there's a famous building known as the Crooked House. It's a 43,000 square foot shopping center that went up in 2004, and it's built to look crooked in honor of the children's book illustrator Jan Marcin Sanzer. There's an indoor amusement park called Wonderworks with a few locations throughout the US, and the building itself appears upside down as if a tornado swept it up and it landed on its roof. A famous house by Verona, Italy rotates on a track to get optimal sunlight. It moves about 4 millimeters per second. It's known as the Villa Girasole because Girasole means sunflower in Italian. There's a chapel in Sedona, Arizona sitting 200 feet above the ground, embedded in a red rock cliff that's about 1,000 feet high in total. The chapel was commissioned in the 1950s by a woman who was inspired by the look of the Empire State Building. Local government in Oostkamp, Belgium repurposed an abandoned Coca-Cola factory into an office building and city hall, and the building's exterior walls look like a forest, and they also added solar panels and a park. The Kettle House in Texas is a mysterious structure in the town of Galveston. No one knows much about the man who built it or who lives there now. All they know is that it's a steel building with a round bottom, and every once in a while someone shows up to work on it. The rest is the stuff of legends. Let's get into some more well-known architects, like James Hoban, who designed the White House. He was born in Ireland and then moved to the US in the 1780s. As for how he got the prestigious job, he won a contest. He also got $500. Ludwig Mies van der Rohe designed basically an entire university campus, the Illinois Institute of Technology. Around the year 1940, the school expanded to 120 acres, and Rohe contributed a lot. He also changed the architecture department's entire curriculum. Alvar Aalto worked on about 200 projects throughout Finland in the 20th century, and his career really took off around the time the country gained independence, so he gets a lot of credit for Finland's aesthetic. He designed factories, homes, churches, and more. Then we have more modern architects, like the recipient of the Royal Gold Medal for Architecture, Zaha Hadid, who recently passed away. She's best known for her use of curves in design, something many other architects stay away from because they're costly. Another architect who's unafraid of curves, one of the most famous architects of our time, is Frank Gehry, who designed the Walt Disney Concert Hall in Los Angeles and the famous Gehry Residence. He went to the University of Southern California, and one of the university's presidents later told him, "After George Lucas, you are our most prominent graduate." He clearly forgot about O.J. Simpson. Gehry also designed the Guggenheim Museum Bilbao in Spain, and this museum is so interesting looking that it gets credit for an economic boost in the city. When a building has this impact, it's now called the Bilbao Effect. And as you probably know, there's also a Guggenheim Museum in New York, designed by another famous architect, Frank Lloyd Wright. It was commissioned in 1943, but didn't get finished until 1959, partly because of the war, and partly because of an architect's greatest enemy, money. Moving on from a beautiful museum to a beautiful parking garage, the Michigan Theater opened in Detroit in 1926. It was a glamorous movie theater that cost $5 million to build. But eventually it got abandoned and then converted into a parking garage. That might sound like a sad fate, but many Detroit theaters never even got converted into a parking garage. You may be familiar with the Cube houses in the Netherlands. These were designed by architect Piet Blom, who in the 1970s redeveloped an area that was devastated during World War II. He divided the plot into sections and made the promise that he'd make it so that you cannot tell that it was designed by one architect.
fact.
Puzzling World in New Zealand also has some cube-like shapes standing at various angles. It's basically a 3D maze and tourist attraction. Inside, there are optical illusion rooms. It also has a sculpture gallery, including a huge floating water tap. The Museum Moderner Kunst in Vienna has some art on the outside, a sideways house on its roof in a piece called House Attack. The installation was created by the artist Erwin Worm, but the building itself had different architects, Ortner and Ortner. Since 1987, about $750 million has been invested into the North Korean building Ruyong Hotel. It's still not open, but it would be a 105-story building plated in glass. Between 1993 and 2008, no work was done on the project due to financial issues. During the Irish famine of the 18th century, some people commissioned projects to help the economy, and one of these people was Catherine Connolly, who had the wonderful barn built in Kildare County. It's 70 feet tall and kind of looks like a giant corkscrew/lighthouse. These structures, by the way, were called famine follies. The vacation home Stone House in Portugal was completed in 1974. It's four separate boulders pushed together with a roof on top, and of course, a pool sculpted into rock. Architect Oscar Niemeyer designed the Contemporary Art Museum in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, and he had an interesting challenge. It was right next to the sea, so he made it a narrow, round building with a curved ramp. It was finished in 1996. Nord LB building in Hanover, Germany is an eco-friendly bank, which was completed in 2002. It's made of steel and glass and looks like intertwining boxes. Okay, let's finish up with some quick facts about unique buildings. The Selfridges building, which houses a shopping center in Birmingham, England, is four stories tall and covered in 15,000 total aluminum discs. The Winchester Mansion, built in the late 19th century in California, has tons of doors leading to nothing and lots of secret passages, possibly because its owner wanted to confuse ghosts. In Huainan, China, there's a building, which was designed by architectural students, shaped like a piano next to a violin. There's an elevator inside the violin. And on that note, there are many buildings that look like other things, like the Big Chicken in Marietta, Georgia. It was built in 1963 and features a 56-foot-tall chicken. Nowadays, it's a KFC. There's a big duck, too. This one is further north in Flanders, New York. It was built by a duck farmer in 1931. The Pickle Barrel House is exactly what it sounds like, a structure shaped like two barrels. It was built as a summer home for a cartoonist who'd worked on pickle advertisements. There's a Coney Island hot dog stand in Bailey, Colorado, a roadside stand shaped like a hot dog. The Dog Bark Park Inn is a dog-shaped bed and breakfast. The rooms are also decorated with tons of dog decor. And since we're on the subject of animals, the Cabazon Dinosaurs are roadside attractions in California. The Apatosaurus Diney contains a creationist museum. Moving on to the Elephant Building in Bangkok, Thailand, it's a 32-story skyscraper with three columns that connect, making it look like an elephant. It also has eyes, ears, and tusks. The Kielce bus station in Poland is shaped like a UFO. It took almost 10 years to build, and you've probably at least seen pictures of the Kansas City Public Library. The exterior is shaped like a bunch of book spines. The Dunmore Pineapple in Scotland was a greenhouse first, and then a big pineapple was added around 1777 to represent hospitality. Welcome to Scotland, home of the pineapple. And finally, I returned to my salon to tell you about another pineapple, the Big Pineapple in Queensland, Australia. It's a souvenir stand, and fun fact, Prince Charles and Princess Diana visited. Thanks for watching Menopause Video, which is made with the help of all of these lovely people. Let me know in comments what you would design a building to look like, and as we say in my hometown, don't forget to be awesome.